Everything that happens in this nano world and related to quantum happens at very low temperature, down to 10 millik, minus 273, minus 272 Celsius is the range that we are working on.
I mean, you mentioned at 0 degrees water freezes out, but then at some point also all the air and all the gas freezes out. But then also if you cool further and further down, also all the movement of the atoms in the bulk material start to freeze out. So basically everything is really frozen at these temperatures. And so for example, to compare it, I always compare it to the temperature of the universe. So this is a little bit more than 4 Kelvin. So here we are working on temperatures many orders of magnitude colder than you have anywhere out there in the universe. So it's really cold, I would say.
Here in Aalto, we aim to develop a key tool to solve most important questions in quantum thermodynamics.
Studying quantum physics or quantum effects basically means that you see the effect of single particles or single excitations. A single excitation has very low energy. And to resolve the effect of these very low energies, you need to cool down all the environment or the background so low that it doesn't affect it anymore. So one reason we are doing it is to build these quantum computing units or quantum computers, where we basically use the very low temperatures to achieve superconductivity in the circuits. And when you have a superconducting circuit, you can build a computer out of them, but this computer does not behave like a classical laptop computer, but it has quantum properties. And with these quantum properties, you can make calculations that are much more efficient and much faster than you can do with any normal classical computer that you have. So, and this can be used in many fields, for example, developing new materials or new medicines, but also in some kind of optimization of traffic flow or things like this.
We have developed an ultra-sensitive and fast thermometry, and this device will be the heart of nanocalorimeter for detecting single photon, microwave photon. If one be able to detect a single microwave photon, most of the problems in this quantum thermodynamic will be solved.